Now, in our first video about intuitionism, we saw that the intuitionists stress that what's going on in logic and math is that we're constructing proofs, and what these proofs really are is mental constructions or pathways to get to a certain construct. And this sets intuitionism apart from its classical counterparts or rivals, which stress truth independent of us knowing it. One way that this comes out is in intuitionism's rejection of what's sometimes called the law of excluded middle, which holds that for every sentence, A, it holds that either A or not A. Now, classically, this holds because truth is mind independent. For instance, consider the twin prime conjecture, which is that there's an infinity of what are called twin primes. That is to say, prime numbers separated only by one digit. So, for example, 5 and 7 are twin primes, so are 17 and 19. And the question is there an infinite number of these or merely a finite number? Well, nobody knows, or at least no one's published anything that suggests that they do know. But on classical mathematics, this conjecture will either be true or false because it's mind independent. Conversely, for the intuitionists, it has this kind of neither nor status because it's not yet proved or proved false. And this tells us something interesting about negation that it's worth lingering on for a minute. If you look at the law of excluded middle again, you'll see that there are two ways to read the negation of A. One is provably not A, and the other is not provably A, or not proved that A, in the sense that we don't have a proof of it one way or another. So for the intuitionists, the law of excluded middle kind of falls apart, because it's not true that for every conjecture or sentence, it's either proved or proved that not. There are many things that we've conjectured that are just not proved at all. And so it's on these grounds that the intuitionists reject the law of excluded middle. It's just not the case that for every sentence A, either A or not A holds, because we don't have a proof of every A.